right, let's get a check of our weather back here at home. As we take a look outside, you can definitely see the haze out there.
Absolutely. Yeah, sky doesn't look very blue, does it?
Mm-mm.
Kind of more of a gray tint to it today. This is the view of the South Salem Hills from our Willamette Valley Vineyards camera. And quite a bit warmer compared to yesterday. 83 degrees, the temperature there. But we're in the upper 80s in Portland. This is our Shriners Hospital camera. Again, you can really see that haze in the sky. Current temperature in the Rose City is 87. We didn't even make it to 80 degrees yesterday. So turning our attention back to air quality, we're still doing fine today despite the haze. I'm seeing mostly good air quality ratings around Portland, one moderate dot. It looks like maybe right around the airport. And then, of course, we're seeing the reduced air quality in the usual spots where those wildfires are burning. So Southwest Oregon seeing some unhealthy ratings there, and then moderate to unhealthy ratings in portions of Northeast Oregon as well. So this wind shift tomorrow is certainly going to be impacting us, like I mentioned, because that's going to bring more of that surface smoke, which is what really ramps up the air quality ratings, or ramps them down, I guess I should say. So here's tomorrow morning, still pretty quiet. You can see more of those kind of red arrows, more so in the eastern kind of portion of the gorge, but that's going to be just enough to push just a little bit more of that smoke into the Portland metro area. Meanwhile, we have that competing northwesterly flow, so it's just a really tricky forecast for tomorrow on who sees clearer skies, smokier skies, who sees the hotter temperatures, the cooler temperatures. I think there could be quite a range in the Portland metro area tomorrow. Then we get to Friday morning. We'll see some additional cloud cover west of the Cascades, should be clearing in the afternoon. And then Saturday, kind of a similar pattern, but potentially even slower to clear with those clouds. So let's take a look at the upper level smoke. We talked a lot about that surface smoke. It's just going to be hazy kind of just everywhere tomorrow because of that switch in the winds. So could even see hazy skies all the way out to the coastline by late morning tomorrow. High temperatures today, again, warmer. Upper 80s is what we're seeing here in the I-5 corridor from Portland down to Roseburg. In fact, Roseburg hitting 90 degrees today. Nice along the coast, 60s and 70s there. And let's check on central and eastern Oregon, seeing lots of 90 plus degree temperatures east of the mountains. So we do have a couple hot afternoons ahead of us here in Portland. We're going mid 90s tomorrow, low 90s on Friday. Wouldn't be record breaking. We'd have to get into the hundreds to hit that, but it's certainly going to make for warm nights. We're going to have a harder time cooling down in the evenings. We think low temperatures will be in the mid 60s in Portland for the next kind of couple of nights. So here is what your Thursday looks like. Hazy, areas of surface smoke, and hot. Temperatures in the mid 90s, light wind tomorrow, so that smoke is just going to kind of sit there. And then I think some haze will linger into Friday before we start to see cleaner air on Saturday and slightly cooler temperatures. Notice we're back in the 80s this weekend. We have some additional morning cloud cover, and then really cool things down next week with temperatures in the upper 70s and maybe even some spots of drizzle. So I'll take you through kind of what's going on there in just a little bit. Pete, Nora?
All right.